Hello students, have you ever tried listing out types of plants in your garden or in your society? Take a pen and paper and start listing out the plants around you. You may know names of some of them. Check whether they are bearing fruits and flowers. What is the shape of the leaves? You will realize that many of the plants around have some medicinal use. Some of them are used in cooking and some are ornamental plants. The plant world around us is so interesting, isn't it? Let's find out a scientific way to divide these plants into different categories. Why do you think we need to do that? And how can we do that? You are aware that scientist Robert Whittaker has made this job simple for us. He proposed a system of classification of living organisms and he classified all living organisms into five kingdoms. So it is known as five kingdom classification. Plants around us belong to one common group which we call plantae, which are multicellular eukaryotes. Do you remember why are they called eukaryotes? Yes, they have membrane bound cell organelles. Remember, plants are the main source of food for us. They have chlorophyll in them and they prepare their own food by a process known as photosynthesis. We call them as autotrophic. They are self-sufficient for their food production. Let's quickly refer to Whittaker's chart to recollect the position of the plants in the system of classification. How can we further divide the plants in more categories so that we understand them better? Can we have some checklists to differentiate between different types? We can also check for common characteristics and group them together. Can we check if they bear seeds? What type of tissue is present for conduction of water and food? What type of seeds do they bear and so on? The plant kingdom is classified into two subkingdoms, cryptogams and phanerogams. How do they differ from each other? Cryptogams are seedless plants and phanerogams are seed-bearing plants. Eichler, great botanist, gave us this method of classification.